It is really common for a Tesla Model Y to have a rear spoiler, and it does look cool. But how does it affect the car's aerodynamics? That is a question we received from quite a few of you amigos. Today, we are finding out. We did two safety simulations, one of the Model Y without a rear spoiler, and one with the rear spoiler. Now, you can get quite a few different sized rear spoilers. Some are only an inch or two long, others are like 6 inches long. For this CFD, we went for quite a large one at around 5 inches. These planes slice straight through the middle of the Teslas. The bottom picture is the one with the spoiler. And the velocity magnitude is shown by the colors here, with red being higher velocity and blue being lower velocity. First of all, the original Model Y has a pretty good weight. It is small and not very severe. I should mention that the drag coefficient of the Model Y is 0.23, and the CAD geometry we have here is a good replica. Our CFD gave a drag coefficient of 0.245. Notice how much the wake is going down though. That is important because that indicates that lift is being produced. Comparing it to the Model Y with the spoiler, the bottom figure, the spoiler definitely pushes the wake more up, making the wake pretty much just horizontal. The interesting thing is that the wake with the spoiler looks bigger, but the drag coefficient of the model with the spoiler is only about 5% worse, which isn't that much despite the visually more severe wake. These videos show that the streamlines on the same plane, and the model without the spoiler clearly has a large vortex dominating the rear. There are some other smaller vortices around the top of the trunk and the rear diffuser, but they pale in comparison. With the spoiler, there's now a little gang of vortices and none seem to be the dominant one, but rather they just coexist. Just behind the spoiler, a bunch of vortices are created, which is likely where much of the drag increase is coming from. You can also see that just over the spoiler, the flow kicks up a little bit, as expected. Now, I couldn't find any information about the lift coefficient of the Tesla Model Y. However, this CFD said that without the spoiler, the Model Y had a lift coefficient of 0.136. I don't know how accurate that is because I have nothing to compare it to. But with the spoiler, the lift coefficient dropped by 39% to 0.083, which is a huge reduction for such a relatively small flow control device. Note that this reduction will largely be over the rear wheels because of where the spoiler is located. And this general reduction is great because you really don't want positive lift because at high speeds, you lose control. So the spoiler is doing a great job reducing the lift and making the car safer at higher speeds. That is the end of this video. If you liked it, hit the like and subscribe buttons, and see you next video. Peace, amigos.